Dear Mom, this is my 23rd letter to you. I know you won't respond, but I'm still writing. Nothing has changed since we last met. Your two little beagle pups, ACDC, are still fighting. I was going through an album on Facebook, reminiscing my last visit to Darjeeling. We sipped on your signature chai while on a swing, as you pointed at the spot where Dad proposed you with a diamond ring. Those were some old memories which no longer live there, as you have shifted to your new home now, but that I don't know where. I had a word with Alfred too. Whenever he talks about me, he remains silent. Hearing this, the birds of guilt do chirp within me, as my heart gets locked up in an asylum. But I know for a fact that you do read my letters, carefully pointing out my grammatical mistakes. One day, the other mistakes will also be rectified, no matter how long it takes. I hope you understand that Pearl was pregnant. I couldn't have left her alone that way. Be by her side when she needs you the most, you did say, back in 2015, when I was still her fiancé. Nevertheless, past is like a marshy surface. The more we'll walk on it, the deeper we'll sink. And to continue building a home on it, that's not a good idea, I think. All I strive to do is look past the mud and cherish the lotus in it. The petals of events open one by one, giving life lessons, I do admit. So Naomi's nickname is Me, so Peter has mentioned here that since the time Me has arrived, the outlook towards life is fresh and new. Your little Naomi just turned 1 month old yesterday. Yes, we have named her after you. The postal service denied sending letters directly to you. Hence, I hope Alfred gave the previous letters to you on time. This one, I'm personally coming and reading out to you at your little home, right next to the mother of time. It has been 1 month since that incident occurred. I might be amongst the last person on the visitors list. Kneeling down in respect as I read this letter out to you, I hope heaven and earth can coexist. Yes, I had my food on time, dear Mom. Alas, I couldn't have your presence, as I sit here and moan amidst the open sky of this pleasance. I hope you went through a pile of 22 letters lying next to you. If not, just read it once before the night comes and the agony returns. I'm sorry back then I had to leave for UK. The hospital bills were tough to pay. Cancer sounds good only in horoscope. I wish it hadn't taken you away. Naomi knew I'll be visiting Darjeeling, so she sent you this lovely sunflower. As the bell tower gave a call, it's an end to our final hour. The watchman gave a whistle too, exclaiming it's time to close the cemetery gate. I'll be coming back tomorrow, Mom, unlike our fate. I'm here for a few more days. Between sunflowers and words, we'll keep uniting. I know you won't respond back, but I'll still keep on writing.